I've seen a lot of supposed hair growth miracles during my time in dermatology. In almost every case, when I dig a little bit deeper into the data, I'm always disappointed, and it turns out it was just a hype. But this time, it's different. There's a medication that I think is going to change the entire landscape of hair loss treatment in the next 5 to 10 years, and its name is Minoxidil.
You idiot, we've all heard of Minoxidil for ages. It's the first thing that comes up. Rogaine, another BS clickbait YouTube video, I guess.
Wait, you don't understand. I'm not just talking about Rogaine for the scalp. That would be such a boring video. I'm talking about oral Minoxidil as a tablet, and the results are gonna rock your world, you impatient little fool. That was to the guy in the sketch, not to you, of course. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about what oral minoxidil does, how it compares to topical minoxidil and the pros and cons of the two there, show you some before and after photos, and then talk about the side effects of this medication and discuss who should and shouldn't be taking it. My name is Dr. Saeed, and I'm a board certified dermatologist living and working in New York. On this channel, I do scientific skincare and hair care content in this case without the marketing BS. So if you're interested in that kind of thing, make sure to follow along. Without further ado, let's get into it. Minoxidil was first developed in the 1970s as a tablet medication, but for high blood pressure. It relaxes the muscles in your blood vessels, causing them to widen and allowing the blood to flow through them more easily. But while they were doing the trials, they noticed a side effect that a bunch of these high blood pressure patients were starting to grow more hair. So they took the minoxidil, turned it into a topical solution, and it's been used for decades since then for hair loss. So how exactly does minoxidil help with hair growth? While we don't know the exact mechanisms, there's a few solid theories that I find pretty compelling, and here they are. Minoxidil, by increasing blood flow, lets more oxygen, nutrients, and growth factors reach the base of the hair follicle. This signals to that follicle that it should stick around, maintaining its activity and size, whereas in other cases like male and female pattern hair loss, it can begin to miniaturize. Minoxidil also increases the amount of something called VEGF, which is vascular endothelial growth factor. This stimulates the production of more blood vessels and therefore delivers even more blood to the hair follicles. Minoxidil increases the expression of something called IGF-1 and keratinocyte growth factor in the hair follicles. Both of these are also signals for the hair follicle to maintain its size and to continue to grow. And finally, minoxidil increases the length of something called anagen, which is the growth phase of the hair, and it also stimulates more hairs to go from the telogen or resting phase into anagen. So all of this results in more hair growth. These are all reasons why topical minoxidil has been the first line hair loss treatment for decades. But as any of you who have used topical minoxidil will tell you, it is really annoying to have to apply it to your scalp every night or even twice a day as some people do. Nobody likes sleeping with a wet scalp or having something rub off on their pillows. And some people even develop really bad irritation or an allergy to the topical minoxidil on their scalp. And the other thing to keep in mind is that no matter how much you put on your scalp, the actual amount of active ingredient that reaches the base of the hair follicle, which is where the action happens, is much, much less than that. Ugh, if only there was a way to get the benefits of minoxidil to reach the bottom of the hair follicle and to not have to apply it to the scalp all the time, almost like if it was, I don't know, a tablet of some kind. Oh my god. Minoxidil was a tablet. Why don't we use that for hair loss? It's funny how things come full circle sometimes. But the difference now is we're not using minoxidil at really high doses as we did for high blood pressure. We're actually using them at tiny doses and still seeing some pretty incredible results when it comes to hair growth. So how well does it actually work? Every indication I have from early clinical trials and systematic reviews and my own personal experience using it in clinic for the last 5 years is that oral minoxidil is the most effective treatment we have at both stopping hair shedding and encouraging hair growth. On screen right now, I'm going to show you some before and after photos of people who have used oral minoxidil, and as you can see, some of the results are amazing. Now, to set expectations, this isn't to say that it will work for everyone or that you're all going to see incredible results. All I can say is, on average, it is the biggest treatment effect I've seen out of anything. So why might it work better than topical minoxidil? Firstly, as I mentioned earlier, you're getting way less of the active ingredient reaching the hair follicle when you apply it to your scalp versus when you take it as a tablet and it gets delivered in the bloodstream right to the base of that follicle. The other reason why oral minoxidil might work better than topical is because in order for minoxidil to work, it needs to get converted into its active form, minoxidil sulfate. When you apply it to the scalp, this transformation has to happen using a follicular enzyme only, whereas when you take it as a tablet medication, there are a lot of other places in the body where that activation can occur, and so you could get way more minoxidil sulfate actually going to the hair follicle itself. So oral minoxidil is better than topical minoxidil because you get more of the active form and you get more of it where you want it to go, which is the base of the hair follicle. But there has to be a catch, right? I mean, what about the side effects? or any time you take something as a tablet medication versus when you put it directly onto your skin, you're always going to increase the chances of side effects in the rest of the body. People were especially concerned when it came to oral minoxidil because we've been using it for decades for high blood pressure, and we have seen side effects like fluid buildup around the heart and in the lungs, which is about as fun as it sounds. However, you have to keep in mind that we've been experimenting with low dose oral minoxidil for the last 5 years, not that high blood pressure dose, and the early indications are that this type of fluid buildup around the heart and lungs doesn't happen at that low dose. But I want to emphasize that word experiment, which I just used, because low dose oral minoxidil is not FDA approved for the treatment of hair loss. We're using it off label. But because doctors like me have been experimenting with it now for around 5 years, with patient consent of course, we're starting to get some pretty good data on what types of side effects we really do see. And the most common side effect, which around 1 in 5 patients experience, is too much hair growth. Now, to clarify, that's not too much hair growth on the scalp, which people are having trouble styling. It's too much hair growth on places like the forehead, the temples, the cheeks, or anywhere else in the body. When you take oral minoxidil as a tablet, unfortunately, it doesn't know which hair follicles you want to stimulate, and it will stimulate all of them. But if you're watching this video, you probably agree with me that having too much hair is a better problem to have than not enough hair, because you can do things like waxing or laser hair removal to get rid of any ones you don't want. And to clarify, that extra growth is a slow process. You're not gonna wake up one morning in werewolf mode.
Come here. Sorry guys, I'm just saying goodnight to Zach.
Another fairly common side effect was a slight increase in baseline heart rate compared to normal, but it almost never crossed the threshold into tachycardia, which is classified as an abnormally fast heart rate. Moving on to the next side effect, around 4% of patients experience leg swelling. And this idea of extra liquid building up in your tissues is associated with the next side effect, which is weight gain. And to clarify, oral minoxidil doesn't make you gain fat, but it can increase your water weight by around 1 or 2 kilograms, even though this does tend to resolve after continued use. And that's basically it when it comes to the common side effects, keeping in mind that every medication can have random rare side effects, but we're talking in generalities. So far, the most common use cases when it comes to low-dose oral minoxidil is male and female pattern hair loss. We have by far the most data showing that it works for this specific use case, but we are starting to get early reports that oral minoxidil may be helpful for alopecia areata, scarring alopecia, and even the shedding disorder telogen effluvium. Honestly, I think low-dose oral minoxidil is the real deal, and I have a bold prediction to make for you. I believe that within 5 to 10 years, oral minoxidil will be seen as an essential treatment in every type of hair loss and hair shedding disorder. So I think everyone with hair loss or hair shedding of any kind will be on oral minoxidil, and then they'll decide, do we add finasteride or dutasteride or spironolactone or PRP or steroid injections or all sorts of other things. But I think the oral minoxidil will always be there because it seems to supercharge the recovery process. But there may actually be some resistance from doctors when it comes to this, because hair loss unfortunately is a pretty lucrative field, and something like PRP injections pays thousands of dollars throughout the year, whereas oral minoxidil is an off-patent, decades-old medication which really doesn't make you that much money. But let's hope I'm being too cynical about that and that doctors only care about what's best for the patient. Okay, that sounds amazing. How do I get my hands on oral minoxidil? Well, oral minoxidil, unlike the topical version, is only available by prescription and not over the counter. This means that you'll need to go through a doctor to get it, and that's likely going to be a dermatologist, because nobody else is going to be comfortable giving you that prescription. It's actually probably even more complicated than that, because a lot of dermatologists are dinosaurs, and this is quite a new treatment. So even if you go see your local dermatologist, they may not want to prescribe this for you because it's not what they're trained with. Or they might make the very fair point that oral minoxidil is not FDA approved for hair loss, and so they don't feel comfortable using something off label. So maybe do your research and give the dermatology office a call ahead of time so that you don't end up wasting a visit. An alternative option, depending on what country you're in, is to use an online consultation service like Hims, Row, Happy Head, or whatever might exist in your own country. These services have you fill in an online form, and then you do an online consultation with one of their doctors, who is probably laying on a beach in Miami, and every 2 minutes presses approve all and sends everyone oral minoxidil delivered to their door. But I want to emphasize again that deciding to take oral minoxidil at this point is a risky thing to do. It's not FDA approved, you're doing it at your own risk. Only do it by consulting with your own doctor or your own online doctor, etc., etc. I also want to clarify that I own no shares in any oral minoxidil company. I don't do virtual visits, so I'm not telling you to book with me so I can send you oral minoxidil. I have no financial incentive in pushing this product. I just want to share with you the early exciting data on a new treatment. So if you like scientific, unbiased content like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and you might want to check out my other video on PRP to compare that as a treatment option for hair loss. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.